Hi guys, welcome back to today's video. As we all know, TrueLab has taken apart lots of laptop power adapters from some well-known brands. But today we got our hands on this fake HP 65 watts power adapter, and we decided to take it apart to see if it could match the quality of adapters from other mainstream manufacturers such as MSI. It's wrapped with a built-in USB-C cable, firstly tear off all plastic films. It adopts a classic HP laptop power adapter design with a matte and glossy surface. And the nameplate is attached to the back, modulates TBN-DA13. It can support input of 100-240V, 50-60Hz, 1.6A. The USB-C output can be up to 20V, 3A, which is 60W. And the USB-A can provide 5V, 1A. It has passed multiple certifications. It also says the manufacturer is Delta, but I don't think so. So we will test the adapter to see its actual specs info. The detachable 3-prong design can protect the user from electric shock. A USB-A port is next to the USB-C output cable. There is a slot at the junction to fix and protect the output cable. And there is a hasp to arrange the cable. The woven cable also adopts the same white and black design as the original one. The size of the adapter is about 97.8 by 54 by 21.5 mm. The length of the USB-C cable is about 1.71 meters. Connected to the TrueLab Power ZKM002C, it shows the adapter supports PD3.0, PBS, and QC5 protocols. And it also supports 5 fixed videos of 5V, 3A, 9V, 3A, 12V, 3A, 15V, 3A, 20V, 3.35A, and a set of PPS. And the USB-A port doesn't support any fast charging protocol. That means the nameplate is correct, at least in the upper part. Next, let's take it apart and check out the internal components. As always, use a spatula to pry along the side of the gap and open it up. Only one of the 3 black wires is insulated with tape. Continue to open the other side. Cut off those outboard wires and take out the PCBA module. We can see it's insulated with some yellow tapes. Tear them all off. There is a gray thermal pad on the back of the PCBA for heat dissipation. The fuse, safety extra capacitor, common mode choke, and filter capacitor around the front of the PCBA. Flip to the back, the rectifier, controller, and optocoupler around the back. TrueLab found it adopts QR flyback topology. After the synchronous rectification, it can output a wide range of voltage controlled by the protocol chip. The input fuse is from Conker SMT series, 3.15A, 250 volts. The safety extra capacitor next to it is from Kali, 0.1 microfarad. And these two common mode chokes are insulated with flat copper wires. The bridge rectifier is from World Industrial. It can quickly dissipate the heat and adopts LSB package. This is a big filter electrolytic capacitor, 82 microfarad, 400 volts. The primary PWM controller of the high-frequency QR flyback topology is from ON Semiconductor. And the GaN FET next to it is from Xinguang and adopts DFN 8x8 package, 650 volts, 230 milliohm. This huge transformer is insulated with tape, and the blue wire capacitor is from JNC. This optocoupler is used for output voltage feedback. The synchronous rectifier is from JJ Micro and adopts PDFN 5x6-8L package, 100 volts, 9.2 milliohm. Those two filter solid capacitors connected in parallel are from HYNCDZ, 680 microfarad, 25 volts. The protocol chip is from Canyon, which is actually a high integrated USB PD fast charging controller. And the VBUS MOSFET below it is from AOS, which adopts DFN 3x3 package. 30 volts, 4.1 milliohm. The synchronous buck chip is actually a DC-to-DC converter from EUTech, which can operate in CC and CB mode. It's used for USB-A output and adopts SOP-8 AP package. And this small solid capacitor for output filtering is from Polycap RN series, 330 microfarad, 6.3 volts. Well, that's all components of this fake HP 65 watts power adapter. After taking it apart, we found the internal heat dissipation measures were obviously not as good as the original MSI power adapter we took apart before, and some components are from unfamiliar manufacturers. But it's also not as bad as we thought before the teardown, so we do not recommend buying these fake products if you have enough budget. Okay, that's all for today's video. You can also click the corners to see other videos of fake products. Please drop a like, leave a comment, and subscribe to us. See you in the next video. Bye!